do with that? So, ladies.
Talking about this one. 23-year-old female needs advice as well.
I blackout had the relationship talk with my ex this weekend. How do I make sure I never actually date him again?
There's a lot to unpack from that. Is she saying she was blacked out when she had a serious conversation?
I think it sounds like it was like I was blacked out. We had the talk, sorry, relationship talk, but you don't want to date him again.
Does she remember? She remembers she had the talk.
Maybe someone told her.
Like him. Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe he told her. Hey, I loved our conversation.
And then you gotta do like a band-aid. Yeah. You just gotta come straight and say, hey, I was drunk. Yeah. That cracker really took me on the head. Like, I don't wanna date you seriously. Ooh, that is harsh.
My advice is to never talk to the person. Really, like, not to ghost. Just ghost them.
You can't ghost them.
But no, they've already broken up.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I did talk once more just to be like, hey,
what I said was true. Yeah. I was drunk and locked out. It was right. But it was also a moment of clarity. Maybe you should write about that
too.
Yeah, I'd love to. I have a lot of experience
with
drunk. Well, let's kick it up a notch. I've got a good one left. Just bring a smile to the face. Here we go. Age 25, female, needs advice. Should I dye my hair blonde? I've been thinking about it.
Ooh. Yes. Yeah. At summer, I wouldn't do it. That would even go my skin tone. But I'm assuming you're Caucasian, so yes, go for it.
I've been thinking about that myself, but maybe you could just start off, like, dip your toe in the blonde hair. Like, maybe you could just do a streak, or you could do highlights, like ombre hair, you could do ombre. Yeah. So maybe just, you know, start off kind of slow and then just go for it.
Maybe you can wear a wig for a week and see if the blonde works for you.
Yeah. Like try all kinds of colors.
A different part of your body, like your arm or leg hair, you can start with that blonde. And then work your way up the body.
I think it's like, my mom always says, trust your gut. If there's a reason you're thinking about dyeing your hair blonde, do it. Because you weren't thinking about it a little while ago, right? But now you are.
I'd be happy to put that article together. I know, like, summer hairstyles, what's hot, what's not, so yeah, I can take care of that.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Yeah,
I think we got everything we need.
Yeah.
Well,
alright! Well, thank you for sharing with us.
We got a lot of
awesome. Well, in a women's magazine, something that you definitely need to keep going is advertisements, right? Because we all know that print media is just on the up and up these days. Yes, it's not. So what we need is to have some advertisers featured that you guys like. We want to make sure that what we put in the magazine is something that is meaningful for you. What products you love, we love. And we want to make sure we're in touch. So all we need to determine those advertisers is for someone to loan us their purse. Thank you.
Germany or a Southwest flight.
right here. Okay, of the book. Bookmark number two. Bookmark number three. This might be a bumpy ride. Bookmark number four. Some turbulence. It could be going down, but this will last.
I mean, let's just face it. This shows that print media is not dead. Right? I mean, honestly, there's so many uses for books. I mean, I could just tear off these pages. Use them to wipe my tears
sure.
if I needed to. Yeah. Carry this around like an accessory.
Yeah.
Like put it on my head to show my posture.
Of course. Look
and
at
that. That in there. And nothing fell.
Nothing fell.
If I needed to, like, let's say I was in a photo with someone taking a selfie who was slightly shorter than me. I could have you step on this book.
Yeah.
And it would raise you. Yeah.
I feel like you're equal.
Yeah. And like it's like that's not it.
That's not it. This,
yeah. Okay.
Yeah. That was excellent. But this all right. This
hold,
is great.
Hold on everybody.
And
we've got
oh yeah. Yep.
We've got Benetint. Benetint. I don't know that I can access what's inside. But it's a rose tinted lip and cheek stain.
Exactly. For a sophisticated lady who wants to confuse people. Yes. It's like if you want smart friends who are sophisticated and know how to put lip balm or how to get it out, you're like, hey friend, get this out.
Mm-hmm. Once you finally open it, you can just take a little bit of that stain and just stain everywhere it's needed. You know? Just go, don't just stop at the cheeks, ladies, just keep going. Just wherever you feel like you should.
Exactly. Oh, see, I figured it out. So there you go, yes. And it's really cute, right? Mm-hmm. Also, if you want to play a trick on somebody, you can like just say this is poison and tell them to drink. Right? And if you have a friend who does that, that's a dumb friend. You don't want to keep that friend around.
Something else that every lady would love to have in their purse is, hello! Beautiful. Look at that. Absolutely elegant. I believe it says so well composed on here, so you're already going for gold right in. If you're having a stressful day and it's showing, just hold this notebook in front of you. And people will know that you're actually so well composed.
If somebody asks you out, and you say, you know what, we're so automatic with our phones now, it's like, oh, not today. You can be like, hang on, let me check. There's a number right there. Oh, actually, it's not a calendar. So you can fake them out and say, from a distance, it looks like a calendar, but it's just for your ideas.
Yes.
Or your list.
Agenda. Also, connect the dots. There's a lot of dots. If you're bored, connect them. A great pocket, okay? We have a lot of stuff, obviously. I mean, it's got to go in a pocket. I mean, anything really handy can go in there.
Yeah, I actually want to investigate what's in this pocket. Oh, my God. You know, I can really relate to this woman because she has health care.
Wear them. I don't know. It's been a long time.
How did you end up with them?
I bought
bought them at Target.
At Target? Were they on sale or?
No.
So when you bought them, like, what was, do you remember what was going through your mind that day?
I was like, these are totally in right now. These are great. And I wore them like maybe 4 times.
Okay. And what was their reaction like when you wore them?
People liked them. I would get compliments.
So why are you wearing them anymore?
They're not that comfortable. They're all high and they're kind of short.
So they're ill-fitting, but trendy in theory. Yes. So they get to stay around.
Yes.
Awesome. Well, thank you for sharing that with us. Now, on the other hand, you might have something that is a total do in your closet, that when you put it on, you feel amazing, and you know you are just ready to take on the day. Like this accessory, this piece of clothing makes you feel like a star. Who has one of those things in their closet that they can tell us about? Yes.
I bought the same dress in 7 different colors.
Nice.
I feel awesome in it every time I wear it. I'm wearing it right now. And it has pockets, so I can hide things.
Pockets, yeah. Very, very important. Gentlemen might not realize how important it is to have his pockets in dress.
Well, it means I don't have to, like, rent real estate in their pockets.
Yes. Yeah. So you're really doing a service to, like, every male that you know.
It's a favor.
You can carry your own dress. Awesome. And do you have other items of clothing that you get in multiples as well?
No.
No?
This is the only one.
And when you bought the dress, did you buy all 7 at once, or is this gradual?
It's been like a year, yeah.
Okay.
But like now, whenever they release a new one, I just keep buying them.
And do you have one that's maybe a favorite that you wear more than the others?
Yeah.
What's that one like?
It's really boring. Yeah.
It's really
like
boring.
Movie. Yeah, it's boring.
Like a classic DC kind of a dress.
Yeah, like Jake who spit up all over me.
and that's what you're into, and that's okay.
Thank you.
Awesome. Well, thank you for sharing that with us. Great. So we have a jump that's high waisted, kind of short, but otherwise really trendy jeans, and the dress that you got 7 of. So let's see what we can do for the fashion spread.
Are you okay?
Yeah, why?
You just look really uncomfortable.
I'm really ready to go to that Miley Cyrus concert. I'm totally ready.
Yeah.
Totally ready.
You know, you could pull those down a little if you wanted.
What?
Those pants? It just seemed high-waisted and short. I feel like you could just run around a little. That was kind of
they were supposed to come up to my chest.
Oh, but what about down here? Is that on purpose too, or?
I mean, isn't this really cool right now?
Did you get a Target?
Yeah.
Yeah. No, those are out. Sorry. But I guess we're still gonna have to go to
Target.
Magenta today, Karen.
Wow, it's better than Wednesday. Absolutely.
Aquamarine doesn't quite work for me.
Yeah, I wasn't going to say because I didn't feel like it was appropriate.
Oh, but you're saying it now.
I'm more agreeing with you.
Okay,
I thought that's what.
Okay, so you were just saving it. So magenta is more.
Yes,
is more
I mean for Thursday it's great. We'll see what Friday brings.
Well, I tell you what, reach in that pocket. Go ahead. Yeah.
Oh, should I guess?
Plastic fork. It's for chopped later.
How convenient.
I know.
It's what every DC girl needs.
Yes. Yes. Reach in that other pocket. Go ahead. Yep. Walk around. Reach in. Receipt from J. Crew. That's in case I need to return the aquamarine one.
This is a good thing to have on hand. Are you gonna save this?
Yeah.
If you want to borrow one, I want you to lose that fork.
Okay. Alright, well I have like 4 in there, so don't worry about it. Okay?
If you want to borrow one, you can.
Alright, because Target really isn't doing it for you these days. Verona,
I mean, before it was the special line. You know, the designers came in and they did a special.
The Isaac was Miss Rocky.
Yeah. Designers, we need a new brand from Porsche.
Well, we've done the Isaac thing.
Sure.
We've done Martha Stewart.
Yeah.
Did anyone like lose Project Runway lately? Mm-hmm.
A lot. A lot of people lose every season.
I say we go for Santiago.
Yes.
Yeah, he is just so fetch. Just gorgeous.
Is Santiago Tarjan?
Ooh,
is he?
Who is Santiago?
I have an idea. It's a little off what we usually do. But how about the president of Brazil, who's recently impeached?
She is clearly now on a budget because she has been impeached.
I want a raise.
Sorry, I'm late.
What do you think you've done?
I've spoken up. I've shown up. I've done what you told me to do. I love this company, and I want to take it to the next level. People just can't run Foot Locker. I mean, people do run Foot Locker, but I want to be. What?
Don't forget to talk about the percentages.
Okay. Yes.
Are they higher or lower?
Where
are the percentages after you've been there?
40%. 40% more Nikes being sold. 38% more New Balances being sold. 85% more socks being sold. That's my forte right there. Socks. Anybody who comes in the store is buying socks. 8.5% of the time out of 10. 8.5 out of 10.
I think you got your raise right there. You are raising the numbers for yourself.
Oh,
see that?
Nice. No. You're not gonna pull that one on me again, okay? Look, people come out satisfied with their shoes, with their socks, and then I talk about sports. So these are things, these are qualities you want.
Now see, this might be where you're losing them, because anyone can wear shoes, not just athletes. So you're trying to branch out. Some new demographics.
So we can't give you a raise until there are non-athletic people buying shoes at Foot Locker. That is your fiscal year goal.
You want to see some nerds out there.
Yeah. Okay. All
nerds
right.
With socks and shoes.
Exactly, I can do that.
Yeah, Foot Locker doesn't give raises. Should
have known. It's because no one asked. That's why they didn't give out raises. Look here, Bethany. All right. You know how you're like real smart, real nerdy, no one really likes you except me?
check.
Yeah. Can you really nerd it up? Like talk about your Game of Thrones and like your Dungeons and Dragons. Come to the store and buy a whole bunch of stuff and put New Balances from me. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Well, that was easy.
Wait. Are you doing what we asked you to do?
Of course, yeah.
Where's the shoe on her foot?
Oh.
Well, they're actually Game of Thrones Khaleesi slippers.
What? All right. Yeah. I didn't think it could be done, but you are literally doing it.
Exactly.
So you're going to have to really talk about this.
Yeah, yeah. She made them.
You're making shoes?
She made them for me, and they are actually a little match.
You're making competitive shoes to Foot Locker?
She's making them for Foot Locker.
No. Okay, boss. This is my roommate. I just told her to come in.
Becky, she left me. That's it. We're done.
Did she say
She just doesn't find me attractive anymore.
Do you?
I don't know what I'm gonna do. This is a blow.
I think it's
could see the color.
It's kind of nice when you touch my hair like that.
I just was identifying it. I wasn't trying to make any type of gesture. Just to clarify.
Because I did just say, like, she doesn't find me attractive, so you could, like, throw me a bone or something. Just
I love the makeup products you choose. I think you choose really great makeup products.
I don't know if I got the stain right, because I just put it here, but I think I'm supposed to put it here as well.
Look, I just never dated a blonde guy who wears makeup. Okay, you wear look better than me sometimes.
Are you jealous? Is that what you're saying? Does this intimidate you?
No, it freaks me out a little.
I think you need to be a little bit more progressive. All right? I see nothing wrong with a man wearing eyeliner.
But it's my eyeliner, Stuart. It's mine. And you knew I wanted to dye my hair blonde.
I'm not quite ready to go to CVS, pick up some Maybelline, go to the counter, and pay for it. I'm trying, but baby steps, you know? Like, it's better if I just borrow yours.
Okay.
Then they don't, you know, they're gonna give me funny looks.
Fine, you can borrow it. But I have to put it on, because it looks a mess.
Hey, Becky, up. Oh my God, Stuart, you look exactly like Becky from behind.
Tom and I said, maybe to rethink this whole breakup thing. We drank so much tequila.
Oh my gosh.
Dad, you are always doing this.
I know.
You are always doing this.
He's coming over.
Bing bong.
Oh God.
Bing bong.
Be quiet.
Okay.
I won't answer the door. Be quiet.
Bing bong, bing bong, bing bong.
Have a happy answer, right?
Hey, Sharon, hey. What's going on?
Hey,
good seeing you.
Nice
hey,
you.
Schnookums. Got you some flowers.
Oh, you didn't have to do that.
I did. No. I mean, we're taking our relationship to the next level.
So,
it's so good. No. Did you hear we're moving in together?
No. Oh, hey, that's
yeah.
What the text said. The text
yeah,
said.
In a few months, we'll probably be getting married.
Okay, so, it was like.
And I really like drinking with her because she gets so loose and flirty and does weird stuff.
Somebody took my phone last night. And was texting him. And his name was Jose. Jose Cuervo. I was not myself. I was Mrs. Jose Cuervo.
She's doing like that what Beyonce does, like sauce of fish. So you're a Jose. Yeah. I'll be a Carlos Danger.